A requested topic from one of our longtime YouTube supporters was to cover the TP53 gene, or the P53 protein. And these are referred to as the guardians of the genome, and that's because they're involved in tumor suppression. And just to be clear, since both of these terms can sometimes have the same saying, TP53 is the DNA, or part of the genome, that then gets transcribed into its corresponding mRNA, which will then be translated into the protein known as P53. And P53 as the protein is able to have a lot of different effects on the cell. And one of these is actually serving as a transcription factor, meaning that it can turn other parts of our DNA into its necessary mRNA and then those necessary proteins. So some of the other effects associated with the P53's ability to be a tumor suppressor are direct and indirect because it's influencing the production of other protective proteins. It's involved in cell cycle control, so serving as a checkpoint as that DNA is being replicated to look for any mistakes or mutations. If it finds them, it's involved in DNA repair, so fixing that DNA damage. But if it's unable to fix that DNA damage, it's also involved in executing apoptosis, which is an activated form of cell death to prevent that cell from passing on those mutations into the next cell as it continues to grow and divide. However, if there's a mutation on the TP53 gene, this will lead to mutations on the P53 protein, therefore affecting all of these different processes that it's involved in. And this is the most common mutated gene in cancers, accounting for over 50% of mutations in all tumors. But an individual can also have a mutated form of TP53 gene inherited, and that's known as Li-Fraumeni syndrome. And this increases the risk of all different types of cancers for that individual. So if you have a topic that you want to learn more about, make sure to drop a comment on this video and stay connected to my channel and Dane Garvin.